Nope, the pause button's the same as the shut off button, so that doesn't work. I gotta keep going, you know. I was gonna try to remember some of the other things. But yeah, let me read that scripture. There's a scripture I was saying about the cities being emptied. And that's how it's gonna be, you know. It says in Isaiah the 32nd chapter, this from the New Living Translation, Isaiah 32:13-15, it says, "Your joyous homes and happy cities will be gone. The palace and the city will be deserted, and busy towns will be empty. Wild donkeys will frolic, and flocks will graze in the empty forts and watchtowers." Interesting. The wildlife is going to take over all the cities and everything. "Until at last the Spirit is poured out from us from heaven. Then the wilderness will become a fertile field, and the fertile field will yield bountiful crops. Justice will rule in the wilderness, and righteousness in the fertile field. And this righteousness will bring peace. Yes, it will bring quietness and confidence forever." So the cities are going to be abandoned, you see. And the wild animals are eventually going to take it over, you know. So all the homeless and stuff, we're going to have to get out of the cities eventually, you know. There's a scripture that says, "Those that in the field will die by the sword, and those in the city by famine and pestilence." So in the field, I think they're going to be shooting each other, you know, by the sword or by guns, you know. And in the city, it's going to be full of diseases and pestilences and famine. That's what that dream was. I had a dog eating a lemon rind, you know, because there was hardly any food to be found there. But so it's just interesting. And what else was I going to say? Oh, I know. Another thing I was going to say was that, you know, it's a mistake sometimes to join churches. Churches have such a control on people. You know, but if you have an assignment just directly from God, you know, from His Spirit telling you what your job is, you have a good thing. Don't lose that, because the churches, they will give you their own assignments, and you'll just be part of a church. That's all. You can't be a prophet of God, because prophets are under no man's control. You know, but churches, they will control you. You know, and that was something I got sucked into a little bit when I was young, because I wanted to figure it out, what was going on. You know, are these churches really not of God at all? You know, and that was the thing that I lost at that time, was being directly directed by God Himself. You know, so churches can have a value in keeping you away from sin and things like that. But to be a prophet of God, that's higher than being in the church, you know. So anyway, I'm going to cut this off for now. Oh, another thing I wanted to mention was that there's a scripture in the Old Testament that says that, that Israel will be gathered again, one by one. And you know how Peter denied Christ, and Jesus said, you know, "You will all forsake me, and I will be alone. Yet I'm not alone, because the Father is with me." When it comes down to the nitty and gritty, you know, no one that wants to die alone. It would be nice if we had a partner to die with, you know, to encourage each other. But Christ didn't have a partner, you know. And those that Christ is bringing, it seems to me that they have to die a death like He did. And that means to be forsaken by everyone. You're not going to be able to have a partner to be martyred with, you know. And that's because God wants us to trust fully in Him. He wants to see if we can trust fully in Him, even without a friend, you know. So, when it comes down to the nitty gritty, when the metal meets the flesh and the blood comes out, you're going to be alone, you know. So don't be surprised at that. You know, Jesus says, "There's many things I want to share with you, but you're not able to bear them at present. But the Holy Spirit will teach you these things when the time comes." And that's one of those things, I believe. That's it, you know. Keep seeking knowledge, you know. Keep seeking knowledge and be willing and ask God to be used by Him as a prophet of His, as an instrument of His to bring light. Only the light that only He can give, not a church or some other man, but only the light that only He can give to enlighten your mind so that He can give you your assignment. Not received from men, but from God. That's what Paul had. You know, but he had brothers to associate with in the first century. I don't see him today. I don't see any that are like the first century. That's why Jesus says, when the Son of Man returns, will he find faith in the earth? Big question, you know. Because by the third century, Christianity became a state religion, the Holy Roman Empire, and it could have been squashed out, because after, when Paul said, after I'm going away, wicked men will enter in who will teach twisted things and will not treat the flock with tenderness. So that happened, you know. So it happened pretty quickly after the apostles died. So then the church survived anyway until Constantine supposedly had the vision, and Christianity became the state religion. And that way, nobody could stamp out Christianity, because the Roman Empire was the strongest, lasted the longest, and was the strongest empire on all the earth at that time, and lasted a long time. So no way was Jesus' name going to be stamped out when you have that kind of strength, you know. The corruption with the Catholic Church was great, yeah. Still is, probably worse now, but yeah, Christianity has lasted all these years and never overpowered by the darkness until right now. It still thrives for all those who have God's spirit. Now, there's tons of fakes, there's tons of imposters, there's tons of punks who pretend, you know, are putting on an act because they think that's what God wants them to do, when they're not really empowered by the Spirit at all. They're just kind of mama boy, milk toast, you know, not genuine. And they'll come out and attack me too. It's amazing. But anyway, you that are real, stick there in there, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.